And now the Seminoles faced with a decision here. Fourth and goal at the five.
Doug Hill, the rover, really put some pressure on Stockstill, made him hurry up that pass, and that's the main reason why that pass was incomplete.
Rendina to try a field goal from the 17. He's already booted one beyond the 50. It's a fake. Rolling to the right is the holder, and he's over. Lowrey scores. Kelly Lowrey took it in for the touchdown. A sophomore from Lake City, as Rendina went through with the motion to kick. Of course, Lowrey kept the football, put it on his hip.
Kevin Lowrey right now is going back. He faced the punt, rolling out, and he's running for his life right now. He sees that goal line, and nothing stops him. Kelly Lowrey scores a touchdown. Excellent play call by the Florida State Seminoles that time. Caught the Buckeyes by surprise. The Buckeyes thought they was going up for the tie. Faked it. Great call by the coaches over there for Florida State.
So Lowrey and the Seminoles engineer the trickery. Lowrey, a 220-pounder, 6'1" sophomore from Lake City. And now Florida State's on top, 16-13, with 12:10 left in the second quarter.
In a tricky play like that, Jack, that's the first time that a touchdown was scored on OSU on the ground this year.
Well, it's another specialty team doing damage. That was the field goal team for the Seminoles, and they turned what appeared to be an apparent try for three into a six-pointer.
Hall's conversion is good.
Is it a gamble by Bobby Bowd? No, it's not a gamble by Bobby Bowd. He knows the percentage is going with him. He's got to get a touchdown. The wide delay after clearing out the middle of all the backs and the wide receivers. Nice call by Bobby Bowd.
Ahead by a score of 17-7 early in the fourth quarter. Look again at the touchdown play.
Bobby Bowd has got an ace for every situation. The old riverboat gambler. Birmingham, Alabama, fourth down, 3 yards to go. What does Florida State do? Miami's in a double zone. He spreads the receivers all over the field and delays his tight end over the middle. He's wide open. Big guy goes in and scores. Orson Mobley.
There's the scoring drive, the 24-yard pass play. To Mobley, good for the touchdown. Johnson converted.
For Kelly Lowrey. There's the backs and receivers. Lowrey, your quarterback. Johnson, your split end. Hester, Williams, and Burnett. Your skilled people on offense. You're looking at Kelly Lowrey. Guys in the truck doing a job there. Nice camera angle of that shot. 7-0 Lowrey. Here he comes. Blitz. Got the screen on the right side. That's Tony Smith. Tony Smith gets to the 5-yard line. Eugene Daniels saves six. Lowrey was in trouble. They had a blitz on. He got it out to the safety. Bowman in the flat.
Take a look. Lowrey dropping back. The strong blitz by the Tigers there, dropping the ball off. Plenty of running room. Picking up blockers there. Britt blocked out of the play. Tony Smith with a fine reception there. Taking the ball down the 5 yards. Greg Allen, let's take a look. See, Greg Allen diving into the air there. All the Tigers are a fooled on the play. The pursuit there catches Lowrey at the goal line for the touchdown. Kelly Lowrey on a bootleg, 5 yards in scoring play.
Phil Hall will attempt the extra point with Lowrey holding. Now we've got a tie football game here at Titan Stadium. Seven plays, 56 yards. It took 2 minutes and 5 seconds off the clock. Culminated by a 5-yard run by Lowrey.
To the left, right over the middle of their big tight end. Carson Mobley. Eugene Daniel on the top. They showed screen on the left side and they threw it to that big guy right there. 6'6", 250-pound tight end.
Let's take a look. Paul Lowrey dropping back, taking screen to the left, looking for his tight end to open over the middle there. And he's clear. He's got the football and down the field he rambles. Eugene Daniel comes in and makes a blocking tackle on him at the 40-yard line after a first down is picked up.
These kids are so up on defense and they react so quick. Lowrey, there goes that screen again to the left side. Smith
Lowrey dropping back, faking the screen, getting the ball to him. Tony Smith picking up blockers, cutting it back across the field. It's wide open now. He's got a blocker down about the five-yard line. He just waltzes in.
Made it look easy.
Eugene Daniels trying to chase him to the end zone.
Philip Hall on the extra point. It's good, and we have another tie at 14 apiece. There's FSU scoring drive.
And a 47-46 lead. Things don't look good at this point for ECU.
And Frank, talk about this fellow Bowden and what he has done at Tallahassee. Well,
Bobby is one of the best offensive football coaches in America. What's significant about his team, they are invariably equally effective with both the run and the pass, and this unit could be one of his very best because he got an experienced offensive line, good wide receivers, an outstanding running back, but more importantly, he's got one of the best quarterbacks in America. Kelly Lowrey last week hit 28 out of 35 for 3 touchdowns and no interceptions, and Florida State wins the game today, he'll play a major role.
He's another one of those big old country boy quarterbacks. He's big and strong.
Four first down for the Seminoles. Kelly Lowrey is a big guy, 6'1", 225, a senior. Second down and a long 7. And Lowrey back to throw. Has good protection down the middle. Pass good to Weegee Thompson, who caught 8 last week for 103 yards. The big guy from Virginia holds this one down at the LSU 40, and it's a first down for Florida State.
When you have a quarterback like Lowrey, that strong rifle arm, you can throw these deep passes. LSU is concerned. Linebackers don't dare drop this deep. The safety man is deep. Look at him throw the ball with stuff on it right over the linebacker's head, and then Hobbit 29 makes the play after a big game.
A lot of freshmen going to be playing today, but virtually all of them are redshirt freshmen. Swing passes out to Cedric Jones, gets a block, breaks it big, gets inside the 25, down to the 20.
LSU has 4 starters returning from a defensive team that finished 4th in the nation. They're talented, but they're very young.
It was a 55-21 LSU win here a year ago, but it was late in the season. This is the opening game for the Tigers today. And Lowrey stands up very quickly. The ball is moved all the way back to the 46. They need second down and 22, and Lowrey's pass goes over the middle to his tight end, Tom Wheeler. And the first time the tight end has had a call today. Well, there's Kelly Lowrey and his numbers so far in the ball game. Coach Bobby Bowden there with him. They've had a goodly amount of time now to talk over their play selection. And we'll keep an eye on the LSU defense as to what they show. And from the 36, 4th and 12.
Don't make any difference where you give LSU the football.
Doesn't look kind of agree with it. Lowrey back. Pass protection. Pass is good. Down to the 22. Pass complete to Hassan Jones. And Lowrey threw a bullet for the first down.
Perfect time, and it had to be. Jones, now, if we get a chance to see it again, let's look at the rule says that the receiver must have 1 foot in bounds while he has possession and control of the football. You be the judge. He has the foot in bounds. He has control of the ball. Legal reception.
Kelly Lowrey, the Florida State quarterback.
Lowrey is a mentally tough young man. You can see he's 6 out of 11 for 76 yards, 1 interception under very adverse conditions. His line has let him down on the pass protection area.
Second down and 12. Ball comes back to the 27. He's going for Thompson. Weegee Thompson is wide open. He's got it just short of the goal line. Just short of the goal line. So Thompson ran in, turned out to the corner, and he's 6'6", and he's made himself a heck of a football player, and he just gutted that one out and beat Eugene Daniels.
Daniels is covering him after he gets by Dale, number 4, inside, precisely what Keith said. The good fake, make him think he's going inside. Now he's behind him. Just a matter of where the ball gets there, and it does. Right on the numbers. That's what an experienced quarterback can do, Keith. He had to throw a perfect pass for it to be completed. Lowrey just deserves a lot of credit on that play.
Kelly is now 10 out of 15 for 119 yards. It's a yard away from the goal line. First and goal for Florida State with 2:58 to play in the first half. Kelly Lowrey, touchdown. So the Seminoles get on the scoreboard.
one of the headlinesmen did signal. The referee has not given the signal, but the headlinesman did. It is a touchdown.
You know, if Greg Allen doesn't drop the football out there wide open,
we got a tie game.
We got a tie ball game. Bobby Bowden was all right. Lowrey back. Gets his pass away. The pass is good to Jesse Hester
into his tight goal line offense.
Okay. Allen's in there at I back. 2 seconds to play. Trying to tie it up. Lowrey keeps it. Touchdown. My goodness. Well, he had Allen trailing, and he had that hole open for him, and Kelly Lowrey steps in.
The right side of that offensive line, fans, is Hart at tackle and Dukes at guard. They both weigh 290 pounds, and that's where they win, right behind them.
What a turnaround we've had. Now, LSU started out like they were going to run Florida State out of the county, if not the state. And now here comes the Seminoles back. The kick is up. Hall, the kick is good, and we're tied 14-14 at halftime. 14-14. Let's go back to this touchdown play as one of the old plays in the playbook.
One of the best ones. You fake to the fullback, and that walls off all the blockers inside, and then it's an option play outside, and Lowrey saw just enough daylight to jump right in.
Kelly Lowrey, gutsy ball player.
Kelly made a great play on that line. He was supposed to pitch it, but they took a pitch, and he kept it. A great play by him.
Good luck the second half.
Thank you very much.
Freddie Lewis comes in to replace him at that linebacker position. Greg Allen's out of there now after that long run with Billy Allen in at tailback. And on first down, Lowrey stands up to throw, goes, and it is touchdown. Pass to Hassan Jones. So Florida State takes the opening kickoff, and they march right down the field with it and take the lead in the ball game for the first time.
Fans, watch the timing. The pass had to be thrown before Jones had ever gotten out around the first secondary man. The timing by Lowrey was sensational. I don't think I've seen any pretty execution of that pass in a long, long time.
Bob Davis will hold, and the extra point try by Philip Hall. It is good. So with 13:01 to go in the third quarter of play, the Florida State Seminoles surge ahead of LSU 21-14. Becoming quite a day for Kelly Lowrey. Two touchdowns running and a touchdown throwing.
He is some football player. His coaching staff, they are very high on him. He's a tough young man. They started out and played some defensive end. Some defensive end to tell you how tough he is. 6'1", 225. Good strong arm and perfectly timed.
Well, he's jacked up right now. It's up to the Florida State defense, however, to quiet the thunder of LSU as they wait for the kickoff. Another look at the touchdown.
The timing is perfect. Lewis, number 45, is to disrupt the pattern, not let the receiver outside. The ball was thrown just as he got, as Jones got by Lewis, and Daniel, 35, could not get there. Perfect execution.
There to West Virginia. Lowrey looks, goes to the corner, and it's Hester. Touchdown. Jesse Hester, pure speed.
You're going to see a perfect throw. It's, you can see Lowrey look to the left. That's the key. It pulls the safety man away from the pass. Hester gets 1 foot in bounds right there, has possession of the ball, and makes it a legal reception.
With the ability of field goal kickers, a missed extra point can haunt you.
Watch Hester run by the up back, who has short coverage. And now you see that Hester is open. Let's see if he catches the ball with 1 foot in bounds. Has control of it. Yes, he's got control of it. 1 foot in bounds. Perfect reception.
And the Florida State Seminoles coming back after trailing 14-0, now lead by 13.
Here we look at Kelly Lowrey. Wasn't the start at the beginning of last year. As we look at his numbers, didn't start to the third game, but came on and hit 113 passes out of 216 and 11 touchdowns. This is his game so far.
I've got to ask you a question. Now, LSU can run the ball, no question about it, right? Why in the world are they... Passes away, and the pass is caught by Weegee Thompson. That's the option with Lowrey. I told you, he weighs 225 pounds, and he is not timid. And he's out very close to the 30. Lowrey.
Lowrey keeping on an option. Goes outside with it. He kept it at a very dead last moment before he gave it to Allen. And Allen runs for another Florida State first down at the LSU 36.
Barry Switzer would have been proud of this option play, Keith. It's a trap option where the fullback will fake up the middle of the guard foot. Now watch the timing. Lowrey waits to the last minute, and Daniels, the cornerback, had gone inside with and is not supporting at all. And you can see how much running room Allen has before Daniels, 35, comes into the play.
Their defensive people started to play in the second quarter.
I didn't believe you could make that dramatic improvement in 1 week.
Look at this. It looks like a fullback. And he's got a first down. Kelly Lowrey bumping and banging his way downfield inside the 35. And it'll be first down Florida State at the 34.
Playing East Carolina. They scored 46 points.
Lowrey option it down and turns it. And touchdown, Kelly Lowrey. That is his third touchdown of the day. At 1:46 to play in a football game, I do believe the Seminoles just slammed the door.
And do quarterbacks make a difference? That's the reason coaches spend most of their time recruiting quarterbacks and coaching quarterbacks, as the big guard Dukes makes the key play, blocking out the defensive tackle and allowing Lowrey to turn up on the option play. And he's not considered a running quarterback, but he's looked good today.
He's thrown for two touchdowns. He's run for three touchdowns, and his team leads 40-21.
All this sets up the pass plays. Watch Kelly Lowrey find a wide open Tony Johnson on the sideline.
This may be Kelly Lowry's toughest assignment of the season, reading the blitz, checking off, and executing.
I look for him to blitz, come after us, and if we can hit him with big plays, then we can get him out of all that. But you just never know. You know, we got to go. That's a long trip out there, and we just want to come over with a W.
Seminoles are on a roll now, two in a row.
Yeah, we're on a roll. You know, a lot of seniors on this team. We have a lot of pride, and it's our last four games coming up, and we just want to win, you know, really bad and get back in that top 20 and then go get a bowl.
Back in the top 20 and go get a bowl. Kelly Lowrey speaks for the rest of his teammates on the Seminole team.
With Tony Johnson even farther out, that's Ouija at the bottom of your screen in the slot in the backfield. Third and six. Lowrey, he's got a complete out of the backfield and down to the 31-yard line for a first down is Greg Allen. With eye back from the 47-yard line. A quick drop. He wasn't open left, so he came back to the right, and it's complete to Jesse Hester. Hester falls out of bounds to stop the clock at the Sun Devil 45-yard line. And that should be enough for a first down. It is.
This is a good read by Kelly Lowrey. He wanted to go to Ouija Thompson. Of course, he was covered. He came back to the secondary receiver, which is Jesse Hester, running a quick out. He kept his feet in bounds, made a fine catch for the first down.
Jesse, a junior from Belglade, Florida. 6 feet, 175-pound junior. It is first and 10 at the 45 with eye backs again and wideouts left and right. Play action pass, and Lowrey finds his man. It's complete and out of bounds at the 35-yard line as Bruce Hill comes up to make the hit on Tom Wheeler, the tight end, the senior from Port Orange.
KC Kelly with the play action fake. Of course, they're in man-to-man coverage again, and the tight end has single coverage, and Wheeler makes a fine grab over the middle. And you can see him looking for the first down marker and very close to it. And it looks like Kerry Thietz made the tackle.
Lowrey doesn't look a bit hampered with that ankle at all.
No, he sure doesn't.
Saw a good look at Tom McCormick, the senior center, leading the way too, laying a block from Panama City, Florida. Lowrey on the option. He's going to keep and run, and he is off and down to the 10 and down to the 7-yard line. Lowrey, first down, stopped by Bruce Hill. A good run, and certainly that ankle is no problem tonight for Kelly Lowrey.
You see Kelly running the option here. This is one of the plays that the Arizona State defense, it does not defense very well. And of course, see Kelly, he runs it well for us. He makes the first down.
Well, that ball is no more than a foot away from the goal line. They got to break the plane, and Bobby Bowden says, let's go for it. Fourth and goal. Big play early. Quarterback sneak. Lowrey doesn't get it right away. Second effort. No indication. Touchdown. There it is. It was a long time coming. But Lowrey gets the touchdown. And he didn't make it by much, just breaking the plane. It didn't make it on his first surge.
Now we got another look at it right here. see Kelly trying to drive it in. All you have to do is break the plane of the goal line with the ball, and he did.
Throw set offense again. Wideouts on each side with the split backfield. Lowrey dropping. Good protection in the pocket. Firing to the right side and caught. A good catch by Tony Johnson and out of bounds. And he's got enough for the first down at the 26-yard line. Kevin Craven on the stop, on the coverage. The Free State team from Cleveland, Ohio. These two teams, without question, will recruit nationally. And all you have to do is look at their rosters and see where the players come from all over the nation.
Tony Johnson, number 82, a senior from Florida State, makes a very fine reception. It's man-to-man coverage. He's running what we call a post corner. He winds up to the outside. He still just don't have a great deal of experience.
Third down, 11. And Lowrey under some pressure, throwing, and a catch around the knees. Is it good? Yes, at the 22-yard line. Weegee Thompson grabbed that one at his knees and takes it out of bounds, close to a first down.
You can see Arizona State once again coming with the blitz by Kevin Gravin, number 6. Of course, Weegee makes a tremendous catch right here. You know, this is what being a receiver, yeah, this is what's being, what is, you know, makes a good receiver, is being able to come up with the big catch. And this certainly is one right here. As you see, look at him go down, concentration tremendous. Yeah.
Florida State has 3 timeouts remaining. Arizona State has 2. Quick pass to Thompson, one-on-one, and he gets out of bounds of the first down at the Arizona State 46-yard line. Bruce Hill kind of slings him out of bounds. Had he been able to break loose there, he would have been down that sideline.
Well, Arizona State coming with the blitz again, except Florida State does a fine job of keeping them out. And Kelly delivers the ball to Weegee Thompson, who is digging for the first down, and you see him right there, he's got it.
Whoa, assistant got the kickoff of the game, and they tell me that they'll leave early. They like to arrive late and leave early. Hassan Jones out of bounds with a first down on the receiving end of a Lowrey pass at the 37-yard line.
Outside, some deeper patterns, especially square end patterns against the man-to-man coverage.
Lowrey with time. And Weegee Thompson could not keep his feet, and he's dropped at the 12-yard line. Dale Walton on the coverage. But Weegee would have been gone for the score. He'd have been able to keep his balance. Well, we want to thank Jack Nicklaus for joining us here at halftime. That was interesting. And of course, it was right at the start of the third quarter, so we didn't have much time to talk with him.
Well, we just talked about the short passing attack, and he finally decides to go deep. Weegee Thompson, really an outstanding athlete. You know,
it's the Seminoles, first and 10 at their own 20. Right away, Lowrey to the air to Hester. Makes a move and almost breaks away. Gets a first down across the 30 and out of bounds at the 35 is Bruce Hill.
Kelly Lowrey.
There he is, number 12, Kelly Lowrey. We talked about him earlier in the game. He was a starter for the first 8 games. Hurt his knee. He is healthy. And Bobby Bowden says he'll put him in if the team needs a spark. A real competitor. So now the offense has to do something. The defense has been on the field much too long here in the first half, first quarter. And Florida is really taking it to them on defense. So the offense has to do their part. Get a couple of first downs. Come up with a big play.
It is Kelly Lowrey at quarterback. They brought Lowrey in at quarterback. 239-pounder has the football. Lowrey pops it out there complete. Taken by Tom Wheeler, his tight end. Bobby Bowden felt, I'm sure, that the time had come, having given up 10 points. He had to get Lowrey on the field.
He felt that he could give them a spark. He is a senior. He is a leader. He is an incredible competitor. Bobby Bowden said about Lowrey, he is the best all-around talented quarterback we've had at Florida State.
Third down, 8 yards to go at the 48-yard line for the Seminoles. Kelly Lowrey. All the time in the world. And it's complete. Second down there inside the 35-yard line. Hassan Jones stopped by Fred McAllister. Jones knocked out at about the 31-yard line.
Bobby Bowden said the key to his offense is giving his quarterback time to throw. He's had plenty of time to throw, and you're going to watch number 88, Hassan Jones, run across the middle. The quarterback still is not under pressure. There's the throw and the catch for first.
Kelly Lowrey. And it's caught. Taken by Hester. Jesse Hester at the 32-yard line. That'll be enough for a first and 10. Mark Korff, linebacker, made the tackle.
Kelly Lowrey has done exactly what Bobby Bowden had hoped, and that's provide a spark. Again, excellent, superb protection for Lowrey as it delivers another strike to Jesse Hester, number 4. Enough for the first down. It was third and about 15. Hester ran the right route to pick up the first down.
He did that. They got 24 yards on the play. Now Tony Johnson comes in as a wide receiver, and Weegee Thompson goes off. Johnson to the left side, Jesse Harper to the right. Jesse Hester to the left, right side. Kelly Lowrey going long, way down there, and Hester's got it. Touchdown. Jesse Hester for the touchdown.
Oh, I love it.
We don't...
A look at Kelly Lowrey. He does it more by force of will than talent. But this ball is beautifully thrown to number four, Jesse Hester. You saw Lowrey look off the defense. He actually looked off the free safety, Tony Lilly, number 18. But absolutely a superb throw and remarkable concentration by Hester. Bobby Powden calls him our most dangerous receiver, and you see why. Watch this catch. Superb.
And so the score is now Florida 10, Florida State 6. Lowrey, since coming to the game, is 3 for 4, 68 yards, and one touchdown. It'll be first and 10 at the 20-yard line. Joe Henderson took it. There is Kelly Lowrey.
He throws pretty good for a guy 240 pounds, doesn't he?
He certainly does.